Well, hello out there in YouTube land. Well, here I am starting on the axe cover. Yeah, finally. So I have benefit of actually already started the axe cover and working on it, and I'm sitting here doing this intro to the video. So I know what's kind of going on with this thing already. And I know that it kind of went south on me. And it's kind of a long video, and I'm having to lay out the axe, draw it on paper, cut out the paper templates, lay it on leather, mark it on there, cut that out, and then start putting everything together and working on it from there. So yeah, it turned out to be a little long video and everything. And as that all transpires, things start going south. So I want y'all to kind of, if you watch this thing all the way through, kind of figure out where it goes south at. Leave your comments below and take and put in the timestamp number as to where you think it goes south at, if you follow me along all the way through it, and let me know what you think. And at the end, I'll give you, I'll talk to you a little bit about the future projects, which I've actually already started, and I'll talk to you about that there. So let's get busy with this and watch what's going on. This is Surviving 2 coming to you with another video. Well, welcome to my secret lab where all kinds of strange things happen. Yeah, you already know what's going on, so it's time to make a cover for this. And I've looked at several different styles, and I've kind of come up with one of my own. It's kind of a combination of several different ones. How do you like the camera view? I've kind of come up with something new here. This way, my big fat hands don't get in the way. I've kind of done some preliminary things, and I've got this drawn up, and what I did to get this was take the axe and put it over the piece of paper and take a pencil and take the outline and draw it like that, and I came up with that right there. Then what I did was I took the shaft and kind of extended it up here. And then back over here, I extended to here where it came through. I extended that, which I really didn't need that because I'm not interested in this side of it. But I am interested in this side staying straight. So what I did was take a ruler and kind of kept it straight there and extended it right on out. Now, I extended it a pretty fair ways, and what I did is once I got it kind of figured out where I wanted it, I took the paper, folded it over like this, and held it tight here, and got a mark here on the edge of the axe, and kind of figured out once I got that, where I wanted, which this was the edge right here, I came back a ways, so I marked that, and that's where my flap will be. Now I took my hardware that I'm going to be using and laid it out at the edge of the axe, gave myself a small amount of room, and gave it some beyond that hardware, and I drew this line and then drew this line here. This is going to be the welt. And when I get to cutting all this out, you'll see, I'll show you some other drawings I did, and I kind of outlined it. There's going to be three total pieces of leather. There's going to be a back, a welt, and a front, and there might actually be a fourth one, because the axe, the thickness right in here might be such that I might have to add a fourth piece and shave it down a little bit so that the two pieces or all the pieces kind of fit in here. I might have to put a fourth piece to take up the space, so there's no space in there, so that it fits better. The top won't matter up here, because when I fold the cover over, that will be taken up by the cover itself, because there's not going to be any the welt won't be up here in this area. It's just going to go from here down and over. So that way my axe blade won't be hitting my fasteners that I'm going to use to hold this portion of the cover together, if that makes sense. And I'm going to probably have one here. I know I'll have one here. I don't know about here. I'm going to be using contact cement too to hold this welt and all this leather together. And I know I'll have one here and probably one here. So there's probably going to be three down here and possibly just two here. I don't know if a third one is going to make a whole lot of sense in that area, because that's just too small of an area. I don't know. Might put a third one in there just for grins and giggles. We'll see as I get to putting it all together. So once I got all this drawn out here, I went to my fax, photocopier, everything, and I made three copies. Bam, bam, separate, bam. I made the three copies there. One is going to be the back, one is going to be the welt, and the other one is going to be the front. So now all I got to do is take and cut each one out, and that will be the pieces, my templates, for when I go to cut the leather out. So what I'm going to do here is pause you and go ahead and cut these out, and then I'll bring y'all back once I get these three pieces cut out, and we'll go from there. All right, I got everything cut out. And now here's my original template. This is the back portion that I cut out. This is actually going to be the back of the leather. I got the leather over here to the side. And this is the front. So I cut it out of right there. And this is the welt right there, and that's the spacer that's going to be going in between the other two. So now let's get all of these pieces, let's get some room. Let me move this out of the way, get all this out of the way, get that stood up there. Leather. All right, now let's get the flap first. Smooth side of the leather. I want to flip it around this way So the smooth side, when I flap over, it'll be showing like that. So I'm gonna place it, get it to cooperate a little. I'll leave a little excess so I can do that. Pencil. Well, that pencil is not gonna fly. Get a carpenter's pencil here. This away. Okay, good. So that works out there. Now this one is going to actually be make sure I did that right, because having to flip and flop and do everything, I want to make sure I got that set up right. So yeah, that will be flipping over, so that will be correct. Now the front will be this direction, and I'm gonna actually bring it down to here. And do it right here. There will be a little waste on this, but that's fine. That is not working out good. We're dead. Some of these tools I've never used before. This is one. I just picked this up. I've never done this detailed of leather work. Most of the leather work I've done, get my big head out of the way so y'all can see. Most of the leather work I've done has just been small stuff. I'm actually learning on this project. Okay. There is a tool that cuts leather that looks like a half moon. I was looking for it at Tandy, looking for it at Tandy Leather. I'll say that right. It's a half moon type deal that you fit in your palm and you put it down and you roll it, and it actually cuts right through the leather, and you can use either of the two tips to cut it really good. But they didn't have it, and I was surprised. I might be able to get my welt out of in between these two right in there, so I'll have this half of the leather left over, or I can flip it, and because it won't matter what leather I use or get, might be able to get it there, something like that. So I'll go ahead and cut these out and do that, and then I'll come back to you guys in a minute. I've got some scissors to cut it out with, so I'll do that and won't bore you with cutting leather. I think y'all know how to do that, or should know how to cut stuff. So I'll do that and then come back to you here in a minute. All right, I got all the leather pieces cut out, and I got this much leather left over for other things if I need it, which, like I said, I'm liable to need a fourth piece for the welt to go in. Now, let's see. There is my front. There is the welt. Whoop, come here, welt. There's the welt. So, this is the cover right there. And there is the front and the welt, which will be right here. It'll go in there like that. And then the cover will go on it like that. Reach down and get Mr. Axe. Now Mr. Axe will fit in here like that. That's where he will go. So yeah, I am gonna need probably a fourth, fifth, and sixth piece in there, because there is gonna be a lot of gap. Wow, I didn't realize that was that thick. Yeah, that's quite thick, because my little pieces that are gonna hold this together are not that thick, and I might have to go back up to Tandy and get some bigger pieces. Come on, open up for me. They are, how big are they? 1/8 inch open back, and I don't know how big, maybe it's an 1/8 inch gap that they present. I'd have to get my, and I don't have my little ruler here handy with me. Come on. I hate trying to get Ziploc open sometime. They're two pieces, naturally got the male and the female, and they're screws. And what they will be is, you'll see the one piece. Let's see if I can. There's the one, and then there's the other one. And they will screw, one will be on the back side and one will be on the front. And then they will screw and hold this thing together. They're big enough to handle maybe four pieces, but that is going to be quite a gap. Wow. And that is not going to be enough. That is a pretty big opening. I don't have that's friggin' 1/2 inch. Oh my God. Okay. 1/2 inch, and it tapers down. Come on. Tapers down and out here to 1/16. That's 1/4 inch right there. And 1/2 inch back there. So yeah, I'm gonna have some fun getting that to cooperate. That's gonna be a lot of shaving. Okay, I'd never measured that before, so that's gonna be a blast getting that to shave down. This welt, I don't know if you can see that or not. That's quite a bit. That's gonna be quite a few pieces. Come on. That's 2, 3, 4, maybe five pieces in there. Yeah. Okey-doke. Oh yeah. You know what I gotta do, and the other videos I've seen them do it, is take the leather, get everything out of my way, is take it and literally shave it down like this, shave the edge off of it, and get it to taper. So I'm gonna have fun doing that. And I think I better get me a new blade and put in there. So anyway, yeah, I am not set to do that right now. I'm gonna have to cut me some pieces this thick and figure out how far I'm gonna have to go with that, and then start shaving them down and getting them to fit into there. And I'm gonna have to probably just get another one of those that is at least a half an inch thick. Get a whole new packet of them that'll cover a half an inch, so that way I can at least have the one back there that'll hold all those pieces together. And I got contact glue that I'm going to be using to hold all this together once I get it figured out, along with these screws. So I'm going to have to continue this video at another date once I can get some more pieces. But it will be immediate for you guys, but it'll be a day or two later for me. So I'll catch y'all in a few seconds. Well, there you go. That's the end of that one. And as you see, that kind of ended up getting pretty big, and I figured things out. As you see, that was, as I edited the film, I kind of figured things out. It was getting way out of hand. And you'll find out in part two that I came to some other realizations and some other stuff. And like I say, this video got kind of long. I'm trying to take the other segments, part two, I'm trying to make it shorter. I'm trying to make all the videos. There's going to be probably three, maybe four other videos to go along with this one. I'm trying to make them shorter so that way they're not so god awful long. And because there's a lot to this, a lot more than I thought there would be. And not ever having done a cover of this magnitude, yeah, there's a lot to it. So anyway, I hope y'all enjoyed that. I hope, if you've never done any leather work like this before, I hope you learned something. There'll be more learning as we go along, because I'm still learning. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed it. I kept you, I need more coffee. I'll catch you on the next one. See you then. Later.
I want to thank you for watching this video, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you want to see more in the future that I put out, just subscribe. Until then, later.